everything by truth, by justice, and by peace. Thank you for that. As we come to a time of sharing our concerns and our joys with each other, there are three things on my mind I wanted to make sure we're all aware of. First, the word that our dear friend Becky Blank passed away yesterday. Becky and her husband Hans Hutner and their daughter Emily, members here at West Maryland for many years. She went on to be the president and chancellor of the University of Wisconsin, was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer about 6 months ago, and entered into hospice care the past couple of weeks, and then died yesterday. Hans texted me this morning. On my phone. He and I chatted yesterday, and he texted this morning to ask if I would pass along these words to the good people of West Maryland Church. Quoting Philippians chapter 1. I thank my God for every remembrance of you, always in every one of my prayers for all of you, praying with joy for your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now. And so we send those words of thanksgiving back to Hans and to Emily, and words of thanksgiving for Becky's remarkable life. A second concern, I think, from the news yesterday, the decision that President Carter has made to enter into hospice. I know Bob and Linda, for instance, have known the Carters for 55 or so years. Bob worked in the Carter of my mom. That song, The World is Sustained by Three Things, by Truth, by Justice, and by Peace, I think could be a motto that President Carter has lived out for all of his 98 years. And so we do give thanks for his life and pray for Mrs. Carter and for President Carter and for their family. The third thing I would mention is a bit of a joy, but also comes with concern. Westmoreland has been so supportive and loving to our new neighbors from Afghanistan, and a family, one of their family members made the difficult decision to go home to be with spouse and children. The good news is that they've arrived safely home. The concern is that this is an ongoing reminder of how complicated and dangerous and fraught the world is. So we pray with thanksgiving for safe travel and pray with hope for this entire family. We do pray with deep concern for our world. And so those are the three things I wanted to bring to this time of joys and concerns. But what are the other things that are on your mind this morning? If you have other concerns or joys that you want to speak into this circle, we would certainly welcome. Providing witness of justice and grace and beauty.